This bait is peaking, man, peaking large. Okay, we're coming tight. We're coming tight.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, mate. Rightio, Iron Pete. Look, they're jumping all around us. Don't you just love seeing kahawai like, oh, look at them, they're leaping out of the water. Free jumping kahawai, don't you love seeing shoals of kahawai, bait fish on the surface. We've got this big rock, current pushing against it. All that feed's pushing to the surface, and this is what these kahawai are feeding on. And this is why we're trolling here, to catch these magnificent fish. Look at this, the way they fight. They're just kahawai, they're blue water kahawai. They're such fantastic sport. We know that they're great eating, fantastic snapper bait, great live baits for kingfish and marlin. And today, they will actually earn us points in our ITM fishing tournament. But of course, our first ones are going right in here, because that is a live bait that could be turned into even more points. Okay, bring one over. Don't lift them out of the water. There we go, that's a nice one. Rightio. So, you've got the camera ready. We've got our dorsal spines up, nose touching the front. Okay, 52. That is 52 points we're on the board. Well done, Jake. The fish lives. We've caught enough bait. We've got points on the board, and we are fishing in the ITM fishing tournament. Team Mongrel Pig Dogs. Oh, 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 oh.
Forecast, strong wind advisory. Northerly 25 knots, gusting 35 knots this evening, and to 30 knots, gusting 40 knots tonight.
Hmm. Doesn't sound so good, does it?
I didn't think I'd give it the outlook, it's too depressing.
You know what that means, guys? Hurry up and catch fish. Yeah, might as well be jigging here, we're on marks. Okay, bombs away. Yeah, marks up near the surface. Jig it back up.
You on?
Yeah.
Skippy.
It's a skippy on a jig. Tuna on a jig, one of our tournament species too. Yeah! And fantastic baits, all right. Now Steph's skippy that he caught, while it is a tournament species for us, it's more important that we use it for bait, because we want some big snapper, possibly even a harp hooker. So we're going to go to a ledger rig, a couple of VMC circle hooks, a nice fresh slab of skippy, live bait on the other hook. We're going to drop that down. We've got Jake on the jig, we've got Pete on the live bait, and we're covering all of our bases. We've really got to get moving in this competition, because as you heard a moment ago, the weather forecast isn't very good at all. Yeah, you want a big snapper, eh, Steph?
What a hole.
Okay, mate, we'll get a livey on the other one, eh? Now, as these guys drop down, what I'm basically doing here, I'm actually using the boat to control our drift and just sort of screw us around and keep us over these the sign of these fish here.
Yep, hold on, yep.
Hang on to it. Oh, drop it back through him, mate. Bugger. Got him on, Steph? Hopefully a snapper one. Oh, you got a snapper. Bloody beauty, good man. Oh, yes. Well done, Steph. Okay, you get him in position. Dorsal spines up. We can make out that there's 53, sweet, 53 points, and he can go home. Well done, mate. I'll let you do the honesty.
Choice on the board with a snap.
With these skipjack tuna in the area, there could be some larger predators around. So we've switched our focus to game fishing before the bad weather forces us back inshore to fish for snapper. There you go. Do the damage, someone. That's the Williamson one too. You beauty. Oh, you got one as well?
Mr. Skippy.
You beauty, skipjack tuna. Now look at that for a magnificent looking fish, would you? So underrated, so undervalued, and yet so accessible. I mean, these things, you can catch them in the summertime, right up against the rocks, out here off the coast a little bit when you're game fishing. Now, we all know that these make fantastic snapper baits when they're cut up, but they also make fantastic live baits for marlin. But as I've recently discovered, if you bleed these things, they are absolutely superb to eat raw, or if you just sear them and slice them up.
Look at that! Woohoo!
Oh, makes a nice sound there, let alone, eh?
It does, yeah.
Good old faithful reel. Caught marlin on that reel, you know? Very real. Oh. Woohoo! Mate, they are a neat little fish.
Get his tail, Jake. Get his tail, Jake.
There you go, mate. It's a fatty. Look at that. Get an anatomy shot of that fish. The colours. I mean, the sun isn't shining today, so it won't quite do it justice, but that is beautiful. This bait is peaking, man. Peaking large. Okay, we're coming tight.
Yep.
Now right here I've got a bit of 500 pound Suffolk fluorocarbon snelled onto a 20 barrow circle hook. I've got my bridle rig, bait needle all ready to go. Here comes my skipjack tuna. Steph's going to be able to swing that in over the side.
Okay,
we're clear. And our tuna is back out. Whoa. And... I'll kick you on your toes, eh, Jake? You can see what our bait can pull like. I was saying how fantastic eating skipjack tuna are. It's not just me that thinks skipjack tuna are fantastic eating, it's marlin as well. Jeez, he's a tough little beggar. Now that electric blue strobing that you're seeing there coming off the propeller of our Evinrude E-Tex is from our Ocean LED underwater lights. They're mounted on the transom, they're shining back at the stainless steel propellers as they spin, and they're strobing all of that electric blue light down into this clear water. And when you think about it, it looks quite a lot like the electric blue colour that's on our live skipjack tunas. So I'm pretty sure that there's something in it. I found so often that since I've had this boat, when I've been trolling four lures, the marlin, I'm raising 90% of my fish on my close-in lures. Now that could be because of the beautiful noise coming out of my E-Tex, but it could also be from those underwater lights that I keep on even during the day. We've got the lights going for us. We've got a couple of beautiful baits. If we don't get a bite from a marlin here, I'm convinced we've got a jinx. Is that a bite? Feet slow down, mate.
They definitely come right out.
Something came out of the water. Yep. This bait is peaking, man, peaking large. Just keep us idling here like that. Carry us on, mate, as you were.
Stink.
After that little encounter, I've decided a fresh live bait's what we need. So we threw out a small lure, and moments later, we're hooked up again.
Yep.
Right, let's make this one count. Skippy, now would be mean. It would be mean, it would be heaven sent. It would be heaven sent.
The donk too, bro.
It's the black marlin jelly bean bait.
Oh yeah.
Okay, we've caught this one right in close to shore. Now, just the camera can show you, right there is land. Right here is our favourite little inshore game fish, the skipjack tuna, and we're going to rig it up and we're going to put it out right here. Now despite the fact that we're so close to shore, that doesn't mean that there can't be a very large predator in here, and I really don't want to say it because I don't want to jinx it, but... Oh, he's waking up, here he goes, click her on, mate. Okay, we're coming tight. We pulled the bait out of it, whatever it was. Damn! Something's had a go, tried to eat that. He's twitching, he's been squashed.
He's been eating again.
Yeah, something's having a go to me. It's a shark, I think. It'd be a rat marker or something, probably. Oh, he's eating it again. Oh, here he is. Look at him. He's all right on it. He just grabbed it. Oh! Not the big bite. Woo! If only that was, see, that was supposed to be a black marlin and that would have been rad. So much for our heaven sent bait. Oh, here he is, there he is. Yeah, I'll bring it in. Come on, you want it or not?
Oh, we put the speed on.
Here he comes. Oh, he's coming at your camera. Oh, let him bite it, let him bite it, let him bite it. Yeah, mate, switched them onto the camera real good. Oh, no, get off my leader. Get us about to grab a hold of him. Cheeky little hooah. Now, that was our skipjack tuna that we'd brought right in here, close to this rock, to live bait up for a black marlin. And there was another oceanic predator in here that took full advantage of it, the Marco shark, and he's completely destroyed that and destroyed my leader when he's at it. They've got a whole bunch of little wee needle-like teeth designed to grab a hold and then tear, not cutting teeth like on a great white shark or a tiger shark. You can see just all the little wee needle holes that are so fine, so razor sharp, and just another thing that likes skipjack tuna. Cowboy goes in. Okay, I'd say that's a bite. Yeah, hang on. This bait's peeking out now too. Yeah, this is a bit. I think we've just arrived in Marco City, all right? Yeah, okay. It's a bit clear, Steph. Okay, next live bait. See how long this one lasts. Okay, we're hooked up to whatever it is. Oh, there he is, we're skull dragging him in. Woo, he's getting upset. Oh, he's not a little one either. Oh, no. It was a big one too. Oh, I'm back. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, he's a bit angry. Come on. Jake, grab him. Oh, it's a blue this time. Skull dragging him, mate. You just let it go. It just seems amazing here that we've got big shoals of kahawai. This is right where we were catching a kahawai this morning. Whole lot of bait fish and cohabitating in the same area as sharks. Now, of course, sharks, like any other fish or any other big predatory fish for that matter, they don't spend their time herring around trying to catch a fish at the risk that they won't catch it. They burn up a lot of calories, a lot of energy, and eventually they could run out of energy, not be able to feed and starve to death. So they shadow the big bait schools that are just around in here, and they wait for one to be injured or vulnerable, and they pick them out. And that's exactly what they're doing with our baits.
Come on, let's get them before this one gets up, eh? We'll catch us some snappers tomorrow.
Here and amongst all of the moored boats in the Whirianga River as well. Well, that's why.
Gale warning in Ford. Westerly 45 knots, turning southwest at 30 knots tonight.
And with a forecast like that, understandably, the tournament organisers have restricted fishing today to within the limits of the river. So the options were stay at home, will come out fishing in 60 knot gales. Ooh. The anchor's gripped. This is us, boys! Here's our spot! Fit for some mud marlin. Look at this. Well, our skipjack tuna from yesterday is our bait and burley for today. And whilst we are, well, as you can see where we are, right in amongst a whole bunch of moored boats in the confines of the harbour, I happen to know that things like trevally, snapper and some very big kingfish come into these shallow harbours. Plenty of burley, it's always going to bring some activity around. Might catch a trout as well, there's that much fresh water in here from the rain last night. Look at that, eh? Hey, first bait. I better get on the radio and call that in. Got a camera for a photo? Try and fill the frame up with the snapper.
Put him on!
I tell you what, that fish would in fact be legal. It shouldn't be legal, but hey, I don't make the rules. And there are folk out there that would take that home, but not you guys, eh? No. Oh, and Pete, you got him on! You got him on! You got him on, Pete!
I have a long stroke there. Holy feels massive.
Oh mate, about a measure that fella, mate.
I got him on too, Pete. I got him on.
Remember, 34's the benchmark, mate.
34's the benchmark. You see, we can operate in centimetres instead of pounds, and it'll be about right today.
31.
You got a good one on that
step. That a boy. Just goes to show you, eh? You were like, you put a little bit of burley out, most terrible forecast, and you can still have a good time, and it can be productive, and you can catch a feed. And look, where we are, we're right in amongst a whole bunch of moored boats. Just doing the basics.
It could be getting close to 30.
Oh yeah, I think your record could be down the Googler there, Pete. Nothing wrong with that one, boy. And well, we're only in 3 metres of water here. Oh, and I've been picked up, Elmi.
There's another one on the line. Oh, and Pete.
35, I know, 37. And just stay there with your camera once you've taken that photo, because we've got another 30 here. Just want to make sure that can't be identified as being my hand. He's a 31er again. There he goes. Whoa! Good wind squall coming down. Another measure job. Oh, mate.
It's a fatty.
It's going to go 40, mate.
45. Goldie.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. There's a measurer.
Holy smokes, it's 35. 36 even, mate.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
I don't know. It's a snapper. It's a nice one. Oh, as the rain comes down. This is still great fun. No denying it. A snapper. Nice. Oh, look at that, mate, hey?
That's a ripper.
Whee! Oh, mate, that was worth coming out for, hey? I mean, it rained last night. You can see by the colour of the water. It's full of fresh water. Basically, everything's going against us. But we've used that fresh skipjack tuna, minced it up for burley. We've got our king salmon burley. And we're catching fish like this in an area like this.
A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app. So wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalog of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.